Very good morning, students. How are you all? I hope everyone is fine. In the last video, we have started the lesson Amazing Animals. We have learned the different types. In Amazing Animals, we have learned the different things, that is habitat, adaptations in animal, food feeding habits, and organ of breathing. This everything we have learned in the last videos. In today's video, we are going to discuss about the movement. Now, what is actually the movement? The animals move from one place to another. Why is it necessary to move from one place to another? Yes, it is very necessary in the search of food. Yes. Now, you have in history, you have learned the concept of early man. Now, what is actually the early man? That people used to move from place to place in search of food, water, and shelter. He started to develop himself. Like that, in the animals move in the search of food, shelter, and to protect themselves from the enemies. So, movement is very important. Now, we have learned the different types of the animals. Right? The animals which lives on the land, the animals they are called as a terrestrial animals. The animals which lives in the water, they are called as an aquatic animals. The animals which means birds, they fly in the air. They are also called as an aerial animal. They are called as an aerial animal. And the insect which they lives on the land. Am I right? This all the animals lives on the land, but this animal live in the water. So that is called as an aquatic animals. Now for each and every animals, if you will see the movements of the animals which are living on the land, water, the flying animals, or the animals which are very small. If you will see the movement of each and every organism, it is different. Now, first we will learn about the land animals. It is also called as a terrestrial animals. Land animals are also called as a terrestrial animals. Now, if you will observe the animals which are living on the land, for example, tiger, lion, if you will see cat, dog, how many legs do they have? If you will see, they have the four legs. Yes or no? They have the four legs. That is, the front legs are called as a forelimb. The front leg, it is called as a forelimb. And back leg, it is called as a hind limb. Are you getting? Now see, if you will see the human being, we also have the four, means two legs. We have two legs and two hands. Am I right? This, we are a well-developed animal. We are also the one kind of animals, but we are the well-developed animal. Why we are called as a well-developed animal? Because our brain is developed. Are you getting? Now, the animals which are living on the land, they have the four legs, that is two. The front leg, they are called as a forelimb. Back leg is called as a hind limb. Now, these legs helps the animals to move from one place to another in search of food and even to protect themselves from the enemies. Now, if you will see for us, we also live on the land. Our legs, we have two legs and two hands. These two hands are well developed and we use to do the different kinds of work. Are you getting? Then, if you will see the reptiles, lizard, tortoise, they also lives on the land. But they crawl on the land. They don't walk on the land. They crawl on the land. Are you getting? They crawl on the land with the help of the short leg. If you will see the reptiles, lizard, crocodile, tortoise, if you will see them, such animals, they have a very short leg. They have a very short leg. They crawl on the land. They live on the land, but they crawl on the land as they have a very short leg. Now, the next animal is snake. Snake also lives on the land, but it does not have the leg. It does not have the leg. They do not have the leg. They move with the help of their body scale. If you will see the snake properly, it has a scale. If they have a scale, they, with the help of that scale, they move their body. They move their body. They don't have the leg. Snake do not have the leg. I hope you have understood about land. The next animal is aquatic animals. So what is called as an aquatic animals? The animals which lives in the water. They are called as an aquatic animals. Now which kind of the animals do we found in the water? Yes, fishes. We find a number of different varieties of the fishes in the aquatic animal, in the water. Now how do they move? Let's see. Aquatic animals like fishes move with the help of their fins. They move with the help of the fins. You can see these fins. While frog and duck use their webbed feet. Now if you will see the frog and duck, they use the webbed feet to swim. Turtle have a four paddle like legs to push the water back and move forward. Now animals like, if you will see the animals like penguins, snails, they live in the snow. For the moment, they use the flipper. Are you getting? This is about an aquatic animals. The next is birds. Now water, how do the birds move? In the class 3rd, we have learned about the birds. Birds use their wings to move from one place to another. They have two legs. Am I right? But these legs, they use to hold the branch. The legs are used to hold the branch or to hop a short distance. There are some birds such as emu, ostrich, penguin. They come under the birds, but they do not fly. Why do they say they are not flying? Because of their heavy body and weak wings. They have very weak wings, and as their body is heavy, they cannot fly. The next is insect. Now, if you will see the different types of the insects, such as ant, butterfly. These are the different types of the insects which are found on the land. Am I right? They have a 6 legs. How many legs do the insect has? 6 legs for the movement. Now, if you will see some insect like a grasshopper, they have a very short leg. With the help of the leg, they can hop on the land. From one leaf to the another. Are you getting? Then there are some insects such as butterfly. Butterfly which uses the wings to fly from one place to another. They use their wings to fly from one place to another. Now, insect lives in the water. Some insect like water boatsman use their leg to swim in the water. Many insect like butterfly, fireflies have wings to fly, which helps them to fly. They have many insect like butterfly, fireflies. If you will see this type of the insect, they have the wings which they use these wings to fly for the movement, for the movement. Are you getting this?
Migration. The periodic movements of birds from one place to another and back to their original homes are called bird migration. Many birds fly long distances in spring season. They build and raise their young in a new home and then return when the climate becomes warm. Birds migrate mainly to avoid shorter days in very cold regions where food also becomes scarce in winter. When the conditions become favorable, they return home. The Arctic tern is the most interesting migratory bird. It journeys twice a year from pole to pole, a round trip flight of more than 350,000 kilometers. Locusts are harmful migratory insects. Swarms of locusts settle on standing crops and destroy them. Many kinds of butterflies also migrate. The monarch butterflies fly from Canada all the way to Mexico. Birds are not the only animals that migrate. There are fish like the Indian shad, which migrate from the sea to the rivers to lay eggs. Eels, the snake-like fish which live in fresh water, go to the seas to lay eggs. The young ones hatch and grow in the seas. Later, they return to the rivers.
So I hope you have understood about the movements in the animals, such as the animals which are living on the land, water, birds and insects. Are you getting it? Today's work is that you have to read this lesson. Thank you.